he would die again. But if it was after Jesus' work on Calvary, this time he wouldn't be going to paradise. He's in heaven.
I think it's interesting when we look at this versus the resurrection account, when Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life." Lazarus came out bound with all his grave clothes on. Oh, look at Jesus. The power of God that laid the perfectly folded in place, including that face mask, folded and in place, proving that truly he was the Son of God. I don't know. I just think it's a neat correlation. Lazarus came forth. I mean, he still had more, whether he could see, couldn't. You know, he came out completely bound. But Jesus was loose. He moved his own gravestone.
Right.
Well, I shouldn't say he moved his own gravestone, but
it's
the power of God just displayed to different men.
That is interesting. I never really thought about a comparison, but that is good. I mean, you're right.
Lazarus was still bound after he was brought back to life with Jesus.
That's a good thought. That's a good thought.
I don't understand. Oh, it's confusing. Years. Now you say, well, some of the guys, the body stays in prayer and spare things. Okay. How come also in the Bible it says, when Christ comes back, the Christians will rise first? Isn't that the spirit?
The dead in Christ will rise first.
Yeah.
So, without getting into a whole lot, understanding that we are made in the image of God. Part of that being that we have a tripart nature. We are made of our body, our soul, and our spirit. Soul will never die. Our spirit, being our emotions, not looking at just your body, but your body also has emotions, intellect, and that's part of your spirit, your soul. When someone dies, their body, which houses their spirit and soul, their spirit and soul is gone. So to be absent from their body, if they know the Lord, is to be present with the Lord. But they don't have their body or their glorified body. So when the Word of God says that at the trump of God, the dead in Christ will be raised first. The body, it's going to be a unique thing. The body is going to be changed, no longer a body of flesh and blood, but a body of flesh and bone is what we know. We look at Jesus, it was a body that still was recognizable. It still ate. It was not subject to the powers of nature. He could walk through walls. So the glorified body is different. So that body is what our bodies will be changed to. If we are alive and remain at the coming of the Lord after the dead in Christ has been resurrected, those that remain, those which are alive, we are going to be changed too. In the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, our bodies are going to be changed. We won't see death like that, but we'll be changed. It's very interesting. Very interesting. The study of death is called thanatology, and it's just an interesting subject in itself, and what our bodies will be like. And you know, we don't even know everything, because we know now we see through a glass darkly, the Word of God tells us. But we'll understand things better on the other side. Someone else.
You know, they talk about fire of God. What does it say in the Bible where the fire of God is?
The what?
Fire of God.
Paradise?
Yeah.
You know, I didn't know the story.
Does it say in the Bible anywhere where it's that?
No. I do know this. Now, let me think here. I don't know that we know from the Bible.
Because you know, L is. Is here on earth somewhere.
And there was a golf fest.
But I can see where paradise would be here on earth neither. I would think paradise is up here somewhere, maybe not heaven, but
I'm not sure.
May I take this one for a while?
Sure.
You got to remember, we have to go back to the crucifixion. Crucifixion is the central point of paradise. Before Christ died on the cross, there was no blood that could cover man's sin. So man could not enter into heaven. So man went to paradise. If we look at the account of the rich man and Lazarus in what is it, Luke chapter 19, verse 16, one of those two, we find that rich man is in hell, but Lazarus is in paradise. Paradise before the crucifixion was in the center of the earth. It was.
Well, we know that there was a gulf that separated them.
It was. Abraham's bosom.
Yeah.
It was down there because Jesus even ascended into the earth as Jonas was in the belly of the whale for 3 days.
Yeah.
So was Christ in the heart of the earth. He ascended down and he preached to the captives there in paradise. When Christ, after 3 days and Christ rose from the dead, that's when paradise got shifted from the best, from what I studied, from the center of the earth to heaven. So there were two different locations. So paradise now is in heaven.
And I think we have to also look at Luke 27, where those saints.
That be the one that was on the boat, where he said, "I shall be with me in paradise."
Yes.
Could that be in heaven then?
Not that day. Not yet. Because it wasn't finished yet.
You will be with me in paradise, Jesus said.
In the center of the earth.
Yeah, but he didn't go down to
the center. Yes, he did. He was in the center of the earth for 3 days. Before he rose.
Yeah, and that stops us from going.
The blood of Christ is what gives us access into heaven because no sin can enter into heaven. Before the birth, the death of Christ, it was the blood of bulls and goats that was sacrificed, but they never did away with sin. They only covered it. It's only the blood of Jesus Christ that covers sin. Once Christ died on the cross, that sin, that blood then was able to cover our sin. And present us blameless before God. Now, when Christ presented it, his blood to the Father is a whole different topic of another story. But before that point, no, we couldn't enter into heaven because man's sin is still there.
So I think we need to go back to Matthew chapter number 12, verse number 40, where the Word of God says, "For as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the whale's belly, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth." So when Jesus died on the cross, well, he ascended to paradise in the heart of the earth, where we know that there is a great gulf fixed between paradise and hell.
Yeah, because even said, Abraham said the gate thought over, neither one because it was the call.
You know what they could see, I don't know. You know, Lazarus and the rich man. And the beggar. Just trying to see if I can.
Lazarus had all evil and the rich man had all good.
We just know that he couldn't pass from place to place. But the reason we have to remember is that even though men and women went to paradise, they went there because of what the blood of sacrifices would do. And the blood of sacrifices could cover sin to make one right in God's eyes. But the blood of those sacrifices did not have the ability to wash away sin, which would give access to heaven.
Okay, he went up to heaven.
But they were
Well, it's translated. Enoch was translated.
Yeah. Well, you know,
he should not see death.
And Elijah went up to the fiery chariot.
I would need to look at that a little closer because I don't know that I know the answer from the top of my head. I would want to look at that a little bit, but both of those men did not die. So I would need to look at that a little bit to be able to give, to be able to think about that without just giving an answer. Well, you know, different people have different opinions on that.
Meanwhile, if he had to go to the theater one and die, so maybe he would have to die.
I know I was raised with strong opinion on that, that that's what a lot of folks felt.
Yeah. And some say Moses. So I don't know.
Well, and once again, because of the bones of Moses, I was raised with a lot of strong opinion. I'm just going to leave it at that. Because I guess I'm one, you can believe something, and it's okay to even share that, but to be dogmatic on something that the Word of God doesn't necessarily say, I guess I'm not there personally.
Because I know some of you, you know, people need one and die, you know, that thing. This might be the one coming down. Because it don't really say that much about Enoch. So we don't know what Enoch really would do. He might have been more than we know.
Sure. Once again, I'll try to look that up this week and see what I can look at on that.
It's interesting, you know.
But paradise is interesting.
Yeah.
And I think that, you know, we are safe to say it was in the center of the earth, or in the earth, deep in the earth, at least from the Word of God.
It had to be away from.
Used to be. What's that?
It had to be away from where the hell was.
We know that there was a great gulf fix. That we do know, that you couldn't cross in between.
Because I remember. Paper, where they said, I think it was in Turkey, where they took down so far that they are jailed and beaten.
I've heard folks reference that and talk about that.
Can you imagine that?
I'm not trying to be skeptical. I don't know. I just stick with what the Word of God says. Oh, definitely. And we know how it's expanding itself.
Yeah, I'd say.
We know that. Any other thoughts?
Yeah, people listen to you.
Brother Eli, brother, I know exactly what you're saying. I understand your frustration.
It just seems like no matter how you tell them, you know, they don't get right, they'll go to hell. They just keep living there right there.
And you know what? I don't think we're any different than Noah, Abraham.
Yeah.
My Abraham was burdened. Pray, God, spare. Can you imagine his frustration, his disappointment? You know what? God has called us to be faithful. We've got to be faithful. Because sometimes I've had to deal with feeling frustrated. You know,
I'm overheaded tagging through to church.
Well, if that would work, I don't know that works. All I can do is live the life. And
might make it worse.
Yeah, that's right. We don't want to do that. Let's say it tonight. We appreciate you being here. I'm sure Miss Folks is sick, but we're so glad that you're here. And hey, no matter who's here, we're going to have church.
Amen.
Amen. God's faithful. I appreciate the Lord. I appreciate everybody's thoughts and bringing things to the table. Amen. Brother Eli, would you close us in prayer?
Oh, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for the word of God. We thank you, Lord, that you said just so much in thy word that we don't always understand, Lord. But just help us, Lord, to understand the most important thing of all, to know that she is safe, that she is here, that she is filled with Holy Ghost, that she is good at so many miracles. And Lord, we touch all those souls that are sick and wicked, Lord. Tell them, Lord, that they'll be in church next time. And Lord, you touch every heart. Oh, Lord, you touch those, Lord, that travel back and forth, Lord. Kill us back, Lord. Oh, Lord. And Lord, you just touch your church that you'll grow and grow for the honor for the glory of God. Not because of us, but because of you, Lord. To thou, and may it work out. And Lord, we just want to thank you. We just want to praise thy holy name. For thou art worthy, worthy of it all. And take care of our family and wife and family, the kids and the soul, and the people we so touch them all. Because thou art anointed, Holy Ghost. Keep us ever, ever in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Praise God.